The ocean, a majestic realm, not only enchants us with its beauty, but also acts as the primary protector of balance on our planet. Picture a vast air conditioner, carefully regulating the Earth's thermal dynamics. It absorbs excess heat from the lithospheric plates and mantle, then expels it into space via the atmosphere. What happens if our cooling system fails? We see a similar situation in nuclear reactors. It starts with critical overheating, leading to a massive explosion. Sadly, we're observing this phenomenon on a global scale today. Each year sets new temperature records. Our main air conditioner has lost its capacity to cool the planet's core effectively and to remove the excess heat from the giant nuclear reactor at the heart of the Earth. But why? Every year, approximately 30 million tons of oil, which spreads a thin film over large areas, leaks into the ocean. Furthermore, the entire depth of the ocean is now saturated with micro and nanoplastics. Oil, plastic, nanoplastic, and various synthetic materials have drastically reduced its thermal conductivity. Such a situation is unprecedented in the history of our planet. The ocean accumulates excess heat and heats up intensely. Imagine it as a boiling pot covered tightly with a lid. Moreover, the warming of the ocean leads to increased evaporation. More moisture in the atmosphere reduces its thermal conductivity, causing the ocean to heat up even more swiftly. It forms a relentless cycle. We already witness how the surplus heat and moisture in the atmosphere trigger extreme rainfall, hurricanes, and mega typhoons of unparalleled strength. Is it necessary to mention the massive sudden floods in Spain, Greece, Bulgaria, Brazil, Turkey, China, Russia, Libya, Taiwan, Kazakhstan, Germany, and many other countries? These extreme weather events have become more common and devastating globally. Scientists are even suggesting the introduction of a new sixth category for hurricanes. In addition, excess heat builds up in the Earth's core, leading to increased pressure in the mantle and consequently increased seismic activity. New areas are experiencing powerful earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. The planet Earth's steam boiler is overheating and beginning to crack. If we do nothing, we'll first see a significant rise in various natural disasters. And once we reach the point of no return, nearly all life is at risk of extinction from supervolcano eruptions or massive crustal ruptures. However, there's a silver lining. If we've managed to disrupt such a powerful system, we can also restore it. The necessary solutions already exist. For instance, we can reduce air moisture with condensation stations. Deploying this technology globally could not just reduce worldwide flooding and restore the atmosphere, but also supply water to areas previously devoid of fresh water access. We can also rejuvenate the ocean's thermal exchange function through profound cleaning. This involves abandoning plastics and hydrocarbons in favor of organic materials and technologies. To remove plastics, microplastics, and other pollutants, autonomous purification stations programmed to detect and collect contaminants can be employed. We possess the means to carry out these and many other measures today, yet why are these solutions not more widely implemented? Why do we have the resources to mass-produce weapons for mutual destruction and wage global wars, but not to save the planet and our lives? What explains this paradox, and how can we alter the situation? What are your thoughts, friends? I eagerly await your comments.